Hello, everyone, and welcome to my talk. My name is Blake Romano. I'm a senior software engineer at Imagine Learning. If you're not aware, Imagine Learning is a K-12 education company. And today we're going to be talking about using Pulumi to empower Kubernetes fleet management. Imagine Learning has an existing internal developer platform, but there were some challenges with it. Particularly, it wasn't really meant to meet our existing enterprise scale. It was built much earlier in the company. We wanted to rethink how we were doing it. And a part of that exercise, we wanted to determine what are the main challenges we were having with the platform. And a few core things kind of came up. One is it was really hard to determine the current state of every environment we managed. The other thing is that deploying wasn't easy. There were multiple different pipelines depending on what you were deploying, how it would go out. And that left a lot to be desired. And the other thing is when we were, you know, building our infrastructure as code in our existing internal developer platform, it was yet another language we had to learn. And we wanted it to be easy to build infrastructure inside of our platform for our platform team and do it reliably and do it to scale to meet our enterprise needs. And what we came up with is to use the GitOps bridge pattern. And if you're not aware, the GitOps bridge essentially bridges infrastructure as code to Kubernetes. And how do we bridge those two pieces of information, what happens in infrastructure, to get it into Kubernetes? And so Kubernetes has access to the information inside of my infrastructure as code. So in our world, we're using Pulumi and Argo CD with AWS and GitHub kind of being some of the bridge. So in our world, what we do is we use Pulumi and we'll spin up the various stacks for each environment we want to create. And each stack will deploy resources into AWS, things like VPCs, EKS clusters, and other platform-based resources. When we've created all our resources, we take the outputs that we care about inside of Kubernetes and we push them into a Kubernetes secret that gets essentially managed inside of GitHub. And this Kubernetes secret is a Argo CD cluster secret. And it contains inside of the annotations all the information from Pulumi, and Argo CD will pick up that information, deploy that Kubernetes secret, which will end up creating a new connection between the clusters. And we have application sets which are using cluster generators. In those cluster generators, we can access that metadata information in our annotations and pass that along to our applications and use them in things like our Helm chart values. And this allows us to take that metadata from our infrastructure's code and use it in any various number of environments and essentially add-ons we want to add to our Kubernetes environments. And so this model allows us to scale to potentially hundreds of different environments if we need to, which really, really meets our need to scale as an enterprise, as well as reduce the burden of the platform team to write our own infrastructure's code in a different language, as well as managing, you know, how do we reconcile the differences between what's going on in infrastructure as code and what's happening in Kubernetes. So why did we pick Pulumi as our infrastructure as code tool? If you're not aware, Pulumi allows you to write infrastructure as code in a language you already know. So there's no more of this typing of like this very weird syntax that I'm not super familiar with, right? If I'm writing my application code and I'm moving into writing some infrastructure as code, it's the same coding language and the same coding semantics that I'm used to, which is really powerful to reduce the amount of context swapping I have. I can also reuse my code. So I can manage many different stacks with different configurations. And I can use things like conditionals to change what's happening in each of my, in the stack config files to change what's happening and what's deploying in each one of my environments. I also have access to the Pulumi UI, and the Pulumi UI is really great to give me things like an audit of all the updates that have happened and what happened during those updates. It also allows me to see what's in state. Because Pulumi manages state, it has all the information about what is currently deployed and what is the state of that resource. So if I want to know, for example, what is the ARN of an EKS cluster I've deployed in stack A, I can go look in the Pulumi UI for that information. It also allows us to deploy to multiple regions or even clouds or other providers that are not cloud providers very fast and easy. So in our world, what we do is we can actually deploy to regions like US East 1, US East 2, US West 2, and we can do it all within a single stack. And it also allows us to deploy to things like GitHub, and we can actually use the GitHub provider to manage files inside of GitHub, which is really powerful and allows for a lot of really, really neat automation. The other thing is there's awesome libraries that Pulumi has and that make it really easy to create reliable and secure infrastructure. So if you're deploying resources into AWS, there's a library called Crosswalk for AWS, which has some of the best practices in how to deploy things like an EKS cluster or a VPC and be able to do it inside a very nice to build construct, which allows us, the platform team, to move very fast where I don't have to worry about creating each individual one of those resources that makes up a VPC. I can create just the core construct, and then Pulumi, using some of the best practices, can deploy the rest of it for me. And based on my information, generate all those resources. One of the big patterns here in the GitOps bridge is this concept of GitOps, right? And if you're not aware, GitOps is where Git is the source of truth for the desired state of your application or your infrastructure configuration. And what we can do in Pulumi to be able to generate or essentially follow that GitOps pattern is to be able to use a tool like GitHub Actions, where essentially when we merge something to main, we do a Pulumi deploy through GitHub Actions for every single one of our stacks all at the same time. And what happens with that is we can essentially ensure that whatever is in Git, whatever's in that main branch, I can go check and validate that that's actually what's deployed. And I always know that those two things should be in sync, right? That's my desired state of my deployed environments. And you may be like, oh, that's kind of scary if I deploy everything at once, right? Using GitHub Actions, we can also do things like a Pulumi preview on all of our stacks before we merge our pull request. So I can validate that I'm not accidentally changing something that I'm not expecting. And using GitHub Actions to automate a lot of this has really cut down our deployment times, but also given us a lot of trust in our system and what we're deploying. And we can also use things like our stack configuration files, which are essentially YAML files that I can use to configure, you know, different things about my environments or my different stacks. So I can configure things like, what is my CIDR block? I can also use it to enable or disable things that I may be promoting into new environments, and I want to slow roll that into various environments. And I can manage that promotion using things like conditionals and those stack config files to various environments. So taking a look at a little bit of code here, on the left-hand side, you'll be able to see how we create a VPC. And you'll notice that this is using the Crosswalk for AWS library. And so I'm not creating things like the subnet groups and the NAT gateways and all those, you know, sub resources of the VPC. Pulumi is creating those for me, and I don't even have to worry about it, right? I'm essentially just giving it parameters about the number of availability zones, which we will always want in every environment. You know, my NAT gateway strategy, my subnet specifications, but I can also configure things for my VPC depending on what environment I'm deploying into or what stack I'm deploying into. So in this case, we actually get information from our stack config file about what is the CIDR block that I actually want to set my VPC for in this environment. On the right-hand side, you can see kind of two examples of where we're dynamically creating resources based on what's in our configuration and actually updating, and in the top case, we're actually updating our EKS AWS auth config map based on the IAM role ARN that's that we're creating inside of our Pulumi code. And we push that metadata that we get from the Argo role into our outputs, which will end up being accessible inside of our Kubernetes manifest, which is really, really powerful. In the case below, we're actually looking to deploy a tool called Valero into our Kubernetes environment. And Valero is an open source tool that allows you to do backup disaster recovery within Kubernetes. And that requires usually an IAM role in an S3 bucket. So in our example, we actually can conditionally enable or disable that component, create the IAM role in bucket, and then output those parameters into our Argo CD cluster secret. And once they're there, we can use our application set and put those values in our Helm chart to be able to dynamically get those values for each environment programmatically, essentially. Which again, keeps our code really, really dry. And you can see this is the code here that we're using to generate our Kubernetes Argo CD cluster secret. And we're actually using the GitHub provider to manage this repository file. And you may be saying, oh, you really shouldn't put, you know, Kubernetes secrets inside of GitHub. The best part about Argo CD cluster secrets is there's nothing really secret, right? We're using an IAM role to get access to other Kubernetes environments. And we're only giving it really metadata that we have in our infrastructure as code, right? So it's already things that are essentially inside of our state in our stack. And so once we create this file, we have Pulumi manage this file. And when there's updates to this file, it will automatically push that into GitHub, which automatically gets picked up by Argo CD, which is very powerful. And so all of this has allowed us to move really, really quickly and also reliably, where I'm not having to worry about, like I said, kind of copying what's in my infrastructure's code outputs and then pushing it in or building some custom connector between the two. Right, I'm using the standardized patterns with Argo CD and with Pulumi to be able to get this connection flowing for any number of environments that I manage. So talking about some of the results that we've had with moving to the GitOps bridge model with Pulumi and Argo CD, we have super fast deployments now to all of our environments at once. So if I need to make a change, for example, to an IAM role that ends up creating a new IAM role that I need to use in Kubernetes, I can get that deployed out within probably 5 or 10 minutes. Because what I'm doing is I merge it to main, you know, Pulumi will go through GitHub Actions and go to do my deployment. It will go into GitHub and say, I need to go update this file with my new IAM role in my annotation. And once we get to that point, Argo CD then picks it up and will regenerate the application, which will cause a new sync of my application. Which is a very powerful pattern to be able to have. The nice thing too is we have a really easy to understand preview of changes. So if you're not aware, right, when I do a Pulumi preview, I get a nice diff of like what is going to change and what specifically is going to change. And using GitHub Actions, I can automate that so every stack shows me that preview before I actually merge it into my main branch and go and deploy it. And so we get a lot of trust in the difference between what's currently deployed and what I'm about to deploy. So there's a lot of trust there that we've been able to gain, which again, allows us to have that trust to be able to merge into main and then deploy to all my environments. The other nice thing too, is we now have this continuity between our GitOps patterns. So it's no longer that just in Kubernetes, I'm kind of having this GitOps pattern where what's in Git is my source of truth. My GitOps pattern is now also with my infrastructure's code. So when I merge to main and everything is deployed and Git is my source of truth for what is deployed in my infrastructure, specifically in my cloud provider like AWS, I now can follow that same pattern between infrastructure's code and Kubernetes, which really allows me to uniform on that standard. The other nice thing too is updates to infrastructure in Pulumi automatically propagate to Kubernetes. So in the example I was explaining before, where I have an IAM role that creates a new one, and I need my Kubernetes manifest to use that new role, right? When I update that output in Pulumi, right, Kubernetes will automatically pick that up through the change in the cluster secret, which is super powerful. So there's no longer this world where, you know, I have to maybe go do environment by environment if I know the change is good, because it takes enough time of my time to go do that change, you know, manually. I now have an automatic way to do that. The other nice thing is I get built-in auditing in the Pulumi UI of changes going on, right? So I now have an easy way to check, hey, what were the changes that went out and what actually changed according to Pulumi. I now also have a reduction in the amount of developer context swapping I have. So I'm no longer using some new language and some new tool to do my infrastructure's code. I'm just doing it in the same programming language I'm using throughout the rest of my day. And maybe one other really powerful thing is building new environments takes hours. It doesn't take weeks or even months potentially to go create a new environment because it's automatic. As soon as I do that Pulumi up and my GitHub action takes control of it, it's gonna go into GitHub. It's gonna go create that new cluster secret. Argo CD picks it up and then it's going and reconciling on Kubernetes the resources that it needs. So it can take you know minutes, hours, to go deploy new environments, not days and weeks like it used to. So I want to thank you for coming to my talk. There is a GitHub repo with example code. You can scan the QR code or go to the link above, and I very much appreciate you listening to my talk.